So a distribution system is shown in the figure is protected by overcurrent system. For proper fault discrimination, directional overcurrent relays will be required at locations. Okay, so from here there is a 33 kV supply is coming from either side. That is here from also 33 kV supply is coming from this point, and from this point also 33 kV supply is coming. So now he is telling for proper current protection, overcurrent protection, which relays are to be directional relays. Yeah. See, to decide on this one, first, what is the zone of relay 1 and 2? Again, I'm telling you, this is the zone of relay 1 and 2. Okay. In this zone, what you do, you exactly simulate the fault in between. That means in the middle of the zone. And you see how the fault currents will flow. And before that, you have to determine the normal current directions. So when the thing is normal, when the system is healthy, the load is present at this point, the load is here, how the currents will flow, the currents will flow in this fashion. This supply will feed the current in this direction. Okay, this is the direction of current flow under healthy conditions, because supply source, from source to load, the current flow will be like this. Here, if you observe, from the other 33 kV feeder, how will be the currents flow? Currents will flow like this. Okay. To the load. Now, so the normal direction of current, that is the healthy currents through the relays, will flow in this direction. In this directions. Okay. Understood? These are the healthy current direction for all the relays. Here, if the fault occurs here, now we are only worried about the directions of 1 and 2, fault current directions of relay 1 and 2. How the fault current will flow? The fault current through relay 1 will flow in this fashion. The fault current through relay 2 will flow in this direction. Understand? Okay. Now, what are the fault current directions of the relay? I am writing on the top. These are the fault current directions which I have written in red. So now you got the normal current direction and fault current direction. This will make you to decide which should be non-directional relay and which should be directional relay. Now tell me, out of 1 and 2, which is directional and which is non-directional? 1 is non-directional. See, when both the normal current and fault current directions are same, you should use the non-directional relay. When the normal current direction and fault current direction is opposite, you should use directional relay in the fault current direction. That is the fundamental idea, isn't it? So, in this context, what will happen? The relay 1 is non-directional relay. The relay 2 is directional relay. Similarly, if you carry out the same exercise for 3 and 4, what you are going to get? What you are going to get? Four is
non-directional.
And 3 is directional in this, like this. Okay. For five, what will happen? You can easily tell for 5. Why? Because in both the conditions, why relay 5? What is the zone of relay 5? It has to protect from the location of relay to the load position. This is the zone of relay 5. So in between, if you simulate the fault, you can notice that both the normal current direction and fault current direction for 5 will be same. So 5 is a non-directional relay. So now, what are the directional relays in this context? Only 2 and 3 are the directional relays. Understand? If the fault current is 2 kilo ampere and relay setting is 50%, CT ratio is 400/5, what is the plug setting? The other name for plug setting is PSM, plug setting multiplier. What is PSM value is asking. So the actual fault current is 2 kilo ampere, then fault current through relay will be how much?
25 amps.
Fault current through relay will be the actual fault current in primary divided by the CT ratio. CT ratio is 400 bar 5. So it will become 2000 divided by 80. So how much it would be? It would be 25 amps. 25. Okay. Now what is the plug setting multiplier formula? PSM is equals to fault current through relay divided by
pickup current.
Pickup current is 50% of secondary CT current. It is 2.5. So plug setting multiplier value is
10 only now, sir.
10. There's, I think the option is not there. Probably this may be 10 is the option. So 10 is the right option. 10 is the right option. You understand? So next we'll discuss the next topic is dead zone problem of directional relay. Dead zone problem of directional relay. So to understand this, first you will recollect our net torque in the directional unit. In the directional unit, the net torque is given by K3 into VI cos of theta minus tau minus K4. We already explained each term, where V is the PT secondary voltage and I is the CT secondary current. Theta is the angle between the PT voltage and CT current. Tau is a design parameter. K4 is the constant restraining torque acting on the directional element. So this is the net torque of a directional unit of a directional overcurrent relay. Apart from this, we also not know that there is one overcurrent unit. Understand? Now, if in the above this one, if theta minus tau is constant, if you make theta minus tau as constant, then what will happen? Cos of theta minus tau also becomes constant. Let us call this constant as K. Now, the net torque relationship will become what? The net torque will become K3 into VI, V into I, into K minus K4 is K4 minus K4. Okay. At threshold condition. Threshold condition means where both operating torque and restraining torque are equal and opposite. That means when net torque is zero. At threshold condition, the operating torque because of this element and restraining torque because of K4, both are equal and opposite. So net torque on the directional unit becomes zero. So which implies what you're going to get? K3, which implies K3 into VI into K is equals to K4. So V into I will become K4, which is a constant divided by K3, which is one more constant divided by K, which is one more constant. So overall, what we are going to get, the product of V and I is some constant. Understand? So what, again, I am reiterating, what is V? V is the secondary voltage of a potential transformer, PT secondary voltage, RMS voltage. I is the CT secondary current. Okay. So if you plot the curve between V and I, V is equals to constant. That means if you plot the curve for this equation, what you're going to get? So this is V. So in this curve, this is the VA is equals to constant curve. VA equal to constant curve. So VA, when relay will operate? Relay operates when the net torque on the directional unit is greater than zero, which implies what is the meaning? When V into I is greater than this K4 divided by K3 into K. Relay will operate when this is greater than this one. Relay will not operate when the tau net, the net torque is less than or equal to zero, which implies when V into I is less than or equal to the same constant. So if I replicate the same thing, when relay will operate above this point, not even on the curve, above this curve. So this is the operating region of the relay, directional relay, understand, like this, above that curve. So where relay will not operate on or below the curve. So that's why I am making it touch that black line. On or below that curve, the relay will not operate. Understand? So that is the operating characteristics. So this green is the operating reason. The red portion is non-operating reason. Non-operating region. Okay. Now, there is some peculiar situation arising here. If you can observe, this point, let me call it as I minimum. So I have drawn the tangents or the straight lines that are just touching the curve at the borders. This is I minimum. Let me call this one as V minimum. Okay. So here what you can observe, whatever may be the fault current, that means fault current can be any value. Suppose if you extrapolate this line, and if you extrapolate the same thing here, okay, like this. So there is some minimum. Suppose the fault current here is 5 times. Here it is 10 times the rated current. Here it is 20 times. So whatever may be the fault current, if the voltage sensed by the directional unit is less than or equal to V minimum. If the voltage sensed by the directional unit is less than or equal to V minimum, the directional relay will not operate. Why? Because, see, for operating point to lie in the operating region, one thing what you have to notice, the voltage sensed by the directional relay should be greater than this V minimum. Okay. So fault current may be very high, but if the voltage sensed by the relay is less than or equal to V minimum, the directional unit cannot trip the fault. Okay. So one point we'll note down. Understand. Will not operate. Understand. Because if the voltage sensed by the directionality is less than or equal to V minimum, then it is whatever may be the fault current, it is not falling in the operating region. Okay. Now, sir, what is the implication of this one? As I told, for every phase, there is a one relay would be there. For our phase, suppose this is Y phase and this is B phase. Okay. So this is R phase, Y phase and B phase, let me say. Now, how the directional unit will be connected? It will be mostly connected in the beginning. The potential transformer will be like this. So for understanding purpose, I am removing these things, because for every phase, the same connection would be same. This is the secondary PT voltage is fed to the directional unit. Directional overcurrent relay. DOR means directional overcurrent relay. And similarly, the CT secondary is also fed to the directional overcurrent relay. Okay. So the PT secondary and CT secondary are fed, and this is the R phase conductor. Likewise, the same connection should be there for Y phase, B phase. Okay. Now, suppose if the fault is occurring at this point, a short circuit occurred at this point. So what is the voltage of this point? Zero. And what is the voltage of this conductor? Zero. Voltage of this point and voltage of this point are zero. What is the voltage sensed by the which point voltage is sensed by directional relay? This point. Point P voltage is sensed by the directional relay. Fault is occurring. Let us assume fault is occurring at Q. The voltage at Q is zero. Okay. Which current is sensed by the directional relay? Suppose this is the fault current that is flowing, IF. So the same IF will flow through CT. CT is sensing the fault current. That is the step down of the fault current. Here it is sensing the step down of the voltage of point P. What is the voltage at point Q0? Now, the voltage sensed by directional relay, voltage sensed by directional relay is how much? VPQ. VPQ. Why? Because at Q the voltage is zero. At P the voltage is sensed by the potential transformer. This is equals to fault current and the impedance from the P to Q. Impedance of the line between the points P and Q. That is, we can write this one as Z line, or not complete Z line. We'll just write for our understanding the impedance between the point P and Q as ZPQ. ZPQ. Okay. If the voltage sensed by the relay, if this voltage after stepping down by it would be divided by some turns ratio. So this value, if it is less than V minimum or equal to V minimum, then relay will not operate. Understand? So if this voltage that is sensed by directional relay, even though the fault current is very high, if the fault occurs very close to PT, then this voltage drop may not be sufficient to drive the directional relay. Understand? So means if you convert this VPQ into the secondary side of PT, dividing with by turns ratio, it may be less than or equal to the minimum, then relay will not operate. So the point on the line where it is connected, if the fault occurs little far away, little far away. Suppose this is a line. Now fault is occurring at this point. At this point, fault is occurring. Now our Q is shifting to here. Now in this case, our voltage drop exactly equal to V minimum. Exactly is equal to V minimum when you convert it onto the low tension side. Low tension side. Then till this point, wherever the fault occurs, the relay will not sense. Relay will not sense. At this point, it is at the threshold condition where our voltage sensed by the PT, voltage sensed by PT is just becoming V minimum. Just becoming V minimum. If fault occurs beyond this point, then voltage sensed by PT will become greater than V minimum and relay will sense the fault. So this distance from the position of relay to the point where the relay cannot sense the fault is called dead zone. It's called dead zone of directional relay. Okay. So what is a dead zone? Dead zone of directional relay is what? Dead zone is the maximum distance from the location of directional overcurrent relay on the line to the point where voltage fed to directional overcurrent relay is equal to V minimum. That means dead zone is the distance from the location of directional relay to that point on the transmission line where the voltage fed to directional overcurrent relay is becoming equal to V minimum. This is the dead zone. If the fault occurs in this dead zone, the directional relay will not be able to sense the fault. Okay. The first point which you have to remember, this directional overcurrent relay which I have connected here, it will sense the voltage from where the voltage is tapped, where the PT is connected. The PT is connected here. So it will sense the voltage of this point. It will sense the current flowing through this point. Any doubt in this? No doubt. So it will sense the voltage of this point and current through at this point. Okay. So depending upon the voltage at this point, that is P, and current at P in the line, the directional overcurrent relay will make its decision. Okay. Now if the short circuit fault occurs very close to directional relay, suppose the short circuit fault is occurring here. So when the dead short circuit occurs, what is the voltage of the line at that point? Zero. Voltage is zero. Now, what is the voltage that is sensed by or seen by the directional relay? It is the voltage drop, zero voltage. So this voltage drop, whatever this voltage drop is there, that is being fed to the directional overcurrent relay. Okay. Again, this voltage drop is stepped down to low value depending upon the turns ratio. Suppose that the PT ratio is 11,000 by root 3 divided by 110 by root 3. So what is the turns ratio here? it is almost 100. So this whatever voltage drop is there, it is again step put down to 100. Okay, that value is being fed to directional relay. If that voltage is less than V minimum, the directional relay cannot operate. The directional relay cannot operate. Understand? Now, if the fault is occurring at this point, let us say, even this voltage is not sufficient. Suppose fault is occurring at this point, even this voltage drop is not sufficient because the voltage that is sensed by directional relay is becoming less than V minimum. So there will be a point on the line, there will be a point on the line where the voltage drop divided by the turns ratio which is being fed to DOR is becoming equal to V minimum. So even then it will not sense the fault, but any fault that is occurring beyond this point, let that point is called T, threshold point. So after T, wherever the short circuit fault occurs, the directional relay is able to sense, because now voltage drop value exceeds the voltage drop divided by the turns ratio of PT exceeds V minimum. So it will be able to sense that fault. So the distance from the location point P to point T where the directional relay is not able to sense the fault, that is called a dead zone. Understand? Equal to voltage drop in the line. What is the voltage drop in the line from the fault point to relay location divided by PT ratio. So if this voltage is less than V minimum, then relay cannot operate. So if fault occurs closer to directional relay, then relay may be less than V minimum. So it cannot operate. Now, so dead zone is the maximum distance from the location of directional relay on the line to the point where voltage fed to the directional relay is becoming equal to V minimum. That is the dead zone. So after dead zone, it will be able to sense the fault.
So how the fault in the dead zone will be cleared, sir? That is the next discussion.
Okay. So first, before going to rectification, why this situation is arising? Why this dead zone problem is coming? So dead zone problem is occurring because voltage and current for directional relay are sensed from same phase. In the previous case, if you remember, we have only R phase line. There is also Y phase and B phase, I told you. So if you sense your how the PT is being sensed, the PT connection, how you are giving, this PT connection you are giving such that and CT connection you are giving is in this fashion. Okay, so all these four are being fed to the directional relay. This is the directional relay. The directional work and relay. Suppose if fault occurs on R phase, single line to ground fault, then what will happen? Definitely the R phase voltage will become less. Definitely the R phase voltage will become less. Okay, but you are feeding the same current, that is R phase current and R phase voltage, to the directional relay. Definitely when the fault occurs on R phase, the voltage that is fed to the directional relay will be very less, because once short circuit occurs, the voltage of that line will become very less. So dead zone problem will arise if you feed the voltage signal and current signal from the same phase, okay. So whenever short circuit occurs in any phase, that phase voltage will be very small. So that's why dead zone problem is arising. To overcome this, what we will do, we will feed the current for the R phase directional relay. So this is R phase directional relay. For R phase directional relay, you feed current from R phase and voltage from other two phases. Instead of R phase voltage, you feed from Y phase and B phase. So now this connection will become like this. You will feed the voltage from like this. Now here, what is the voltage which you are feeding? VYB. What is the current which you are feeding? IR. Understand? So in this way, even though the R phase there is a short circuit, there will be voltage, very less voltage drop in R phase, that will not affect our directional relay operation, because it is getting that voltage from the other two healthy phases. So in this way, we can avoid the dead zone problem. So this type of connection where the current is fed from, suppose if directional relays are like this, for R phase directional relay, directional overcurrent relay, how you are feeding the currents? Current voltage. Okay. Current you are feeding from same R phase, voltage you are feeding from YB. For similarly, for B phase directional relay, how will be your feeding? Current you will be feeding from B phase only. Sorry, let me go for Y phase first. Current you will be feeding from the Y phase itself, but voltage will be feeding from B and R. So similarly, for B phase directional relay, you will be feeding current from B phase only, but voltage from R and Y. So such a connection is called 90 degree connection of directional relay. This connection is called 90 degree connection of directional relay, which is the best connection. 90 degree connection of directional relay. Very easy to remember. That particular phase directional relay, same phase current will be there. That is R phase means IR. So after R, what is the other two things you will get in clockwise you go? You will get after R YB. So voltage will be YB. Understand? Even for the Y phase, the current will be from the Y phase only. After Y, what you are going to get? R YB. After Y, it is B. And after B, it is R. So voltage we are feeding is VBR. And similarly for B phase, current is from B phase. And voltage is from, after B, what is the next term? R and Y. So this is called a 90 degree connection or clockwise connection. Clockwise connection. So this will avoid dead zone problem. This will avoid dead zone problem for most of the faults. So previously dead zone problem occurred
when we have connected voltage and current from the same phase, that connection is called 0° connection. So previously the connection where the dead zone problem occurred, that connection is called 0° connection, where you are connecting the both voltage and current from the same phase to the directional relay, 0° connection. So in 0° connection, you will have dead zone problem. To avoid that, what connection we are making? We are making 90° connection. So why it is called 90° connection also, I'll give the logic. If you write the phasor diagram of voltages, this is say, this is VR, VY and VB. So relay, most of the times it offers zero resistive impedance. So your IR will be in phase with VR. And what is VYB? If you understand what is VYB, VYB means VY minus VB. Okay. So the minus VB will be like this. It is exactly opposite to this one. This is minus VB. So if you add these two vectorially, if you do the phasor sum of these two, so your resultant will be, this is VYB. VYB. So for the directional relay of R, you are feeding current from IR and voltage from VYB. The angle between IR and angle between IR and VYB is how much? 90°. So that's why it is called 90° connection. That's why this is called a 90° connection. So likewise, in 0° connection, you are feeding voltage and current from the same phase. Both are in phase. So what is the angle between the current and voltage fed to the directional relay? In this case, it is 0°. That is angle between VR and IR is 0°. So that's why it is called 0° connection. Okay. The next important point is this 90° connection is the best connection. It will eliminate 90° connection, will avoid dead zone problem for LG, LL and triple LG faults. Why? Because if LG fault occurs, then also VYB will not become very small. Even if LL fault occurs, then also at least B phase voltage is being fed. Even LLG occurs, then also some net positive high voltage being fed to the directional relay. So directional relay will not cause dead zone problem. The problem arises when three phase short circuit or when both three phases connected to the ground. Suppose the fault is such that all three phases are shorted and connected to ground, then you cannot avoid a dead zone problem. For triple L and triple LG faults, there will be dead zone problem, which we cannot eliminate. For triple L and triple LG faults, dead zone problem cannot be avoided. Understand, gentlemen? So these are some important points which you have to remember regarding the directional relay. Okay, any doubt? So dead zone problem is there once you do the 0° connection. That means if you feed voltage and current from same phase, then dead zone problem will arise in directional relay. So to overcome that, we'll be feeding, because it is R phase current relay, current must be fed from the R phase, but the voltage we are feeding from the other two phases. So this is avoiding dead zone problem for most of the faults, because these faults are very rare, only 3%. These total faults are only 3%. So 97% of faults, it is avoiding dead zone problem. So the most, there are other connections also, 30 degree connection, 60 degree connection, out of which we are not discussing all connections of directional relay. Only the best connection is 90 degree connection. So we have discussed that connection. Okay.